What is up, YouTube? It's Ryan, Maniac Vichu, and I have another tutorial for you guys today. This is going to be a basic 3D text sort of illusion kind of thing in Cinema 4D. It's not really, or Cinema 4D, sorry, in Photoshop. This can be done in CS5, CS4, CS3, CS2. So if you have any of those, don't be afraid. This will work. So I'm going to go ahead and get my type tool out. And this is 3D text tutorial, guys, 3D text. And type Ryan, and the font is Beavis, by the way, you can see up there. I'm going to go ahead and center it like this. And I'm going to go ahead and enlarge. Alright. Now I'm going to go also, and I'm going to go rasterize my type. And I'm going to duplicate it. And then with this below, right here, I'm going to Command-T or Control-T or, you know, free transform, and we're going to scale it using Shift and Option. Now, what Shift and Option really does is, it's sort of, we're going to zoom in a lot here, and we're going to get it so it just barely scales, okay? That's fine, if you want. And what Shift and Option does, now duplicate this layer again, and on the bottom one, we're going to Command-T or Control-T again, and we're going to barely scale it down, just a little bit, okay? Now we, on these bottom two layers, we're going to Shift-click on them and merge them. Shift and Alt, what it does, Shift keeps the proportions and Option, on Mac it's Alt and Option. So Shift and Alt, what it really does is it Shift keeps the proportions and Option scales it from the center. Then we're going to go ahead and duplicate this bottom layer again. And on the very bottom layer, we're going to zoom back in. Sorry, guys. And Control-T or Command-T. Click the corner, Shift and Alt. Drag it in just a little bit. Actually, we can go a little bit more now because we have these layers stacked. That was a little bit much, so we're going to redo it. You don't want to see a lot of edges. Yeah? So that looks good. So now we're going to merge these bottom two layers again. And Command-J or Control-J on the bottom one again. We are going to resize just a little bit like that. And then go ahead and merge again. And we're going to do this about two more times. So, bottom layer, we're going to scale down, Shift and Alt. Okay. And now, merge. And last time. So, bottom layer, Shift and Alt. You can actually do this as many times as you want to get the effect you want. And now, since we've been merging these layers, we have a little room to kind of expand our layer. So I'm going to do it that much. I'm going to merge these layers. And now with the top layer, I would suggest renaming this. Sorry. So Ryan Top. And then I would rename this to Ryan Depth, because this really is our depth layer right here. So what we're going to do, we're going to zoom out again. And we're going to go to effects, and we're going to go to gradient overlay. This is just a tip. And I'm going to just do mine chromish, kind of, so darkish gray, and then I will choose a lighter gray. So let's move this up and move that up too. So now we can just have this sort of chromish looking text. And now for the back, you can do another gradient overlay. And make this one sort of darker. I'm going to make mine dark, dark gray. It's kind of smoky. And a lighter, not too light, gray. And just sort of drag it on like that. And you can also, if you want the effect, you can make this radial. Looks kind of cool. Linear is fine, alright? And there's your basic 3D text, okay? Now if you zoom in, you can see we created the illusion with many layers. It's really just an illusion. If you really want to go a step further, you can add a stroke. Now, I'm going to make it 2-pixel stroke. And then on the back, you also have to add a stroke as well. What I would recommend doing is making them the same size, stroke. You can, make them the same size. And I would make this top stroke just a tiny bit lighter, maybe like that, okay? And now we have our kind of sketchy looking text. If you wanted to, you could make a little bit of gloss, okay? So you can also change the stroke color. The reason mine looks kind of sketched is because it's a black stroke. But if you wanted to, you can highlight or click these both, okay? And it selects both of them. I did that by using Control and then Control and Shift, or Command and then Command and Shift. And go ahead and take the elliptical marquee tool and sort of, hold Alt and sort of just drag out like that. And you can fill it with a gradient of white to transparent. So what this does, make sure it's linear. What this does is sort of gives a little bit of gloss to it. I want to now turn the opacity down. It sort of gives that lighting effect off to it. So that's just basic 3D text, guys, in Photoshop. Now this can be done with objects, too. If you're doing like a circle, I would recommend doing it a different way. But for now, that's just basic 3D text in Photoshop, guys. So thanks for watching. Hope you pick up some tips from this tutorial. And also, one more little tip just to make your text look a little bit better. You want to go grab the line tool, which is under the shapes. It's a line tool. And whatever size your stroke was, mine was 2 pixels, make that your weight. And whatever color it was, make that the same. And I would just go here and see your there's little spots where there should be a line connecting. I don't know why that's messed up. 2px. There should be a line connecting here to here. That's what a normal 3D object would have. So I'm just going to go ahead and make that line myself. And there should be a line down here as well. So I'm going to make that line myself. And that's pretty much all the lines I need to make myself. But yeah, and now you see when I click off of it, looks quite normal. So thanks, guys. This has been a 3D text tutorial in Photoshop. I hope you guys liked it, and I'll have some more tutorials next time. See ya.